In this macro photography tutorial, we'll be taking a look at circuitry. I'll be getting nice and close to this stuff, getting some aerial shots and cityscape style abstract shots using some interesting lighting and this scrap circuitry. I'll be getting started in just a sec, so stick around. Hi guys, I'm Ben from AdaptLux and welcome to another macro photography tutorial. Today's subject is circuitry and circuit boards and scrap electronics. I think this is going to be a really interesting shoot. It's one that I've wanted to try out for quite some time now because I think getting close up with a macro lens is going to give me the opportunity to create some really interesting cityscapes and skylines, maybe even some aerial shots of futuristic urban areas as well. Looking at these circuit boards with all of the different components on them, I can tell you that this is going to be quite interesting when we get up close. I've gone out and got some circuit boards because I've never really had any scrap circuitry around, but this stuff is pretty common. I actually went down to my friend Jerome, who runs an IT repair shop, so he's given me a few different, I think these are graphics cards, but I've also got a motherboard as well, and they're all in different colours. They've all got different interesting components and features on them, including, well, this one's got a big fan, this one's got a heatsink on it, so these are going to be really interesting to shoot. I'm going to set my camera up in a couple of different ways, maybe do some handheld shots as well, and you guys can follow along with any scrap circuitry that you have at home as well. The first thing that we need to do is decide what kind of shot we actually want to take. So there's a couple of things that I have in mind for this subject, and the first one is shooting down from above and creating sort of faux aerial shots of a sci-fi cityscape. These things do look an awful lot like very complex cities, especially this motherboard with lots of different components and chips on it. I think shooting down from the top onto this is going to make some really interesting shots, especially if we can go exploring around here and find some of the more interesting features. You need to remember that these things have two sides to them as well. You've got all of these components on one side, and then on the other side is all of the tracks that that join them up. So these can be really interesting to shoot as well. To get this aerial shot, the first thing that we actually need to do is set up our camera so that it's pointing straight downwards, like I've done just here. I've got this set up on the edge of my coffee table so that the legs of my tripod can go either side of the corner of the table, and then I can put my circuit boards down here underneath the camera. A really important factor for taking a shot like this is to make sure that your camera is parallel with your circuit board. We want to get as much of this thing in focus as possible, so if your camera is at a slight angle, you're going to get one corner of your shot in focus and another corner of your shot out of focus. If the front of your lens is parallel with your circuit board, then everything can be in focus with a relatively shallow depth of field. Our depth of field is going to be really important for all of these shots, taking advantage of it with our cityscapes and also trying to eliminate it with our aerial shots. So the first thing that I want to do is actually just bring in a little bit of light into my shooting area over here. And I've done that with that white lighting arm, and I've popped a cyan color filter on there as well. And that gives us a little bit of directional lighting just coming in from the side, as if maybe a cool alien sun is setting on this this strange looking city. I've also got some orange lighting arms and another blue lighting arm, which I'm going to play around with, and adding these colours in one by one and experimenting is going to give me some really cool effects. Now, there's no science to this. This is just play around and see what works with the colour of your circuit board, with the types of components that are on there, and with the angles that you can find by moving this stuff around. Now you can see that my focus is currently up on the top of these components rather than down on the bottom of the board. And that's because when I flip this thing over, It's going to be more focused on the actual board because it's the same height as those top of those components would have been. I'm already pretty excited just from first glance at this first board, and I've got three more boards to try out, all with different features and components on them. So that's going to be my first task, is putting each of these boards under the camera, moving them around underneath the lens, and trying to find some interesting spots to take shots with. I am going to be moving my subject rather than my camera. My camera is quite nicely situated and I don't want to touch that. Under here I can quite happily shuffle my boards around and find those interesting shots. The first shot that I found is somewhat of a sunrise. I've gone over to my big motherboard and there's a really, really detailed patch of solder and track lines that look very, very much like an inner city. What I wanted to do was try and make it look like the sun was actually rising over this city and we're taking a shot from above. What I've got here is a single white lighting arm S, which is pointed sort of across the bottom of the board, very, very shallow. It's kind of only really picking up on the slightly raised bits of solder, which almost makes it look like city lights are turned on. I then also have an amber lighting arm pointing down at another corner of my frame so that it looks like there's a little bit of glow from the sun coming up. I think this is a pretty good opening shot, so I'm going to keep exploring. I've changed boards, I've also changed the height of my camera because I found quite an interesting little section of this blue board here. It's almost like a quad or some sort of factory, and there's lots of lines going in, there's lots of little soldered components in there, so I think this looks really nice. I've gone and used my my cyan colour filter and a red lighting arm at the same time to get a little bit of colour contrast in there. And this is pretty much the aim of the game with this stuff, looking around, trying to find interesting features and then lighting them using colours and diffusers and different angles to try and find some really interesting shots that look a little bit like futuristic sci-fi cities. I'm going to do a little bit more of this, I'll show you some of the results, and then we'll take a look at creating some skylines and cityscapes. I think it's time to take a look at the other side of our boards. There's a lot going on here. There's a lot of components all jutting out in different positions and different heights, which is going to be a real challenge for our depth of field. I think it's going to be quite interesting to try and focus on here, and we're probably going to come out with some quite interesting abstract shots with only one or two of these components in focus at once. Of course, you can try focus stacking and getting a lot of your board in focus at once. I'm not going to be doing that today, just because I want to get some quite interesting shots with my depth of field being part of that. I think we're going to get some interesting bokeh as the light shines around these reflective pieces, and I want to explore that. To that end, I've got just a single white lighting arm here at the moment, which is giving me quite a nice little working light, and I'm going to be going freehand with my camera. I'm just going to hit record here, and let's take a look at what we can actually see through the viewfinder. So as you can see here, as expected, we've got quite a shallow depth of field. Now, creating a full landscape on this side of the board is going to be pretty tricky because, as you can see, there's a lot of this board that is out of focus at any one time. However, I think that we can still get some really interesting shots by exploring some of the really unique components here. I can see that there's a couple of what look like electromagnets of some sort. If you know what these particular components are, let me know down in the comment section. But I think these look pretty cool, and I think I can get a shot of these which maybe make it look like some sort of futuristic power plant or maybe processing plant of some sort with these big strange structures. What I'm actually going to do here is change my lighting around so that it's a little bit more interesting and not quite as straightforward as just a white overhead light, and see if we can't get a little bit more intrigue into this shot. I've just popped an orange colour filter onto my white lighting arm there. Let's have a look at what that looks like now. And instantly you can see that that's added a really interesting effect, almost like a sunset in the back of the shot. So we can actually use this to our advantage, keeping an orange or a yellow light in the background, make it look like the sun is setting on our cyber city, as it were. As you can see, our depth of field is a bit of a challenge here because we're not getting very much in focus, and I'm shooting at f8, so it's not a very shallow depth of field, but it's shallow enough that we can't fit a whole board in focus. At this point, this is where you would want to photo stack, taking multiple images and blending them together in the background, but I'm pretty happy with this out of focus sort of dreamy look that we've got going on. I think it's quite sci-fi-esque. The last thing that I want to do here is to actually flip my board over again and take a look at this this side with all of the tracks on it, because I wonder if changing the scale of our buildings will actually help that depth of field effect and our sunset to try and get a bit of a skyline going on. There are little raised pieces on the back of this board, and I wonder if we can't make them look like a very distant city and skyscrapers. So I'm going to take a look through our camera one last time and see if this has any interesting effects. I think putting that orange light off in the distance and creating a very dreamy sunset can actually make it look a little bit more like one of those futuristic cities that we see in the movies, very Blade Runner-esque. I'd like to know in the comments which style you prefer, shooting down from the top and creating those aerial shots, or using our depth of field to create those sort of very dreamy sci-fi cityscapes. Every one of these circuits is unique, and the more of these boards and scrap computer components that you can get your hands on, the more variety of different components and features that you'll have to explore using your camera, either from the top down perspective or from the side. I've had a lot of fun exploring today and using my different colored lighting to create different effects. If you've enjoyed watching the video, make sure to give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe for lots more macro photography tutorials, ideas, and inspiration coming in the future. For now though, guys, thank you very much for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.